Hello and welcome to Trojan Talk. I'm your host, Aaron Taylor. My guest today is Judy Robertson, interpreter training program here, but also here today on behalf of the Helen Keller Committee to talk about the Helen Keller Lecture. I want to thank you for joining me here today.
Thank you for having me.
And the Helen Keller Lecture is what we're talking about today, and this is a major event here on campus. It's been one of probably the big events on campus every year people look forward to, because mm-hmm. especially because of the level of speakers that are brought every year for the Helen Keller Lecture. But for the uninitiated, can you give us kind of a little background on what the Helen Keller Lecture is and what it's designed to do?
Well, basically, the Helen Keller Lecture was birthed of an idea from Dr. Hawkins and Mrs. Hawkins several years ago, in a way to sort of highlight people with disabilities and how they've overcome adversity and been successful in life. And so since then, like you said, we've brought several distinguished speakers to campus and tried to create some events around that to bring awareness of disabilities and how people interact and how we can interact with those people as well in a positive manner.
And it always seems to be every year that whenever one of these speakers comes, and whether or not, depending on, it's a wide variety of ranges, that there have been actors, actresses, filmmakers, mm-hmm. Celebrities. And so an opportunity for people to see people across the spectrum that have been able to succeed with the limitations that disabilities might have put on them. So
right. When you look at success is not defined by wealth or by mm-hmm. How famous or popular you are. It's simply defined as, how well you function in life. How well do you overcome those difficulties that you're faced with? And I think through the years, we've managed to bring a wide variety of people that showcase that in different ways, not just by being wealthy or mm-hmm. by famous or whatever, but that have just different talents and different attributes and different things that they contribute to society.
And in particular, being a blind man who has climbed the tallest mountain in the world.
Right.
So an opportunity, which is
right.
what we're talking about at this year's Helen Keller Lecture.
So. Right. I think when you think about someone who climbed a mountain of any sort or, did anything of that sort of, that
magnitude.
Yeah, you automatically think of, well, how did he do that blind?
Mm-hmm.
Those of us who are sighted, we depend so much on our sight, and I think we don't realize how much we do until, maybe we lost it or something. But, thinking about, wow, what a challenge he had, what he was faced with just to tackle this and to get through and be successful at it as a blind person is just incredible.
And we're talking about Erica Weinmayer here, who mm-hmm. They have the copy of his book here, No Barriers, and this book talking about the fact that we talked about Everest, but he also kayaked the Grand Canyon.
Yeah,
so,
I mean,
this guy's done it all.
Yeah, I mean, again, you think about, I think for me, if I were to kayak something, I would definitely, want to rely on my sight. And just it's incredible just to think about how he overcame the adversity he had and went through.
And he's been here before. This is for anybody who's attended the Helen Keller Lecture, it may sound familiar because he has been a guest mm-hmm. in the past, but there's another level of familiarity with him and this book in particular, especially to some of our students here on campus.
Yes, you're correct. Last year, in 2018, it was the freshman reader. So all of our freshman students were required to read this as part of their studies. And so we already have sort of an excitement around the book, around Eric, before he comes to campus, because many of the students have already heard of him.
And of course, in the book we've got it here with us, but telling a story, obviously, about kayaking the Grand Canyon, but climbed Everest, kayaked the Grand Canyon, but a chance to hear him mm-hmm. tell these stories. That's one of the best parts about
right.
it, because you can read this book and probably take away a lot of it, but
right.
then hearing him tell his story, and I'm sure there's some things that probably didn't make it in the book that you're going to hear at the lecture.
Oh, yes, so. I'm sure there are, and I think the main thing that we take away from this is just his ability to overcome adversity.
Mm-hmm.
We talk about adversity, and in his book, he talks about how, adversity challenges us. It may not, but for most of us, adversity is something that feeds us. It challenges us to do better. And that's really what his story is about. And I'm excited. I know our faculty and staff and students over in the College of Education, we're very excited to hear from him. So.
And for anybody out there who wants to hear from him, mm-hmm. once again, he is the keynote speaker of the Helen Keller Lecture this year. And when and where is that going to be?
So we would like everybody to attend, mm-hmm. obviously, students, faculty, community. It will be held in the Claudia Crosby Theater at 10 o'clock. on October the 16th.
October 16th mm-hmm. at 10 o'clock, and it is free and open to the public.
Free and open to the public.
So anybody out there who wants to take part in this, they can take part in this lecture and hear an amazing story about a man who's done some amazing things that I know I personally will never accomplish in my life. So
I know, right?
I'm not going to do it. Everest is not in my future. So, but Judy, I want to thank you for joining me here today and an opportunity. And not to mention, he's also going to be around for, there's something else happening that day too,
he
right?
He is. So, he's going to hang around and watch some Troy football, watch us take on South Alabama that night. So we'll be recognizing him on the field. But so he's going to be around all day.
Students will have the opportunity to see him,
possibly get their book signed. So
he'll be around campus.
So bring your book to the lecture. I'm sure we'll be able to
opportunity because most freshmen should have it. So
they should.
All right. Well, Judy, thanks for joining me today.
Thank you. Have a good.
Thank you for joining us on today's edition of Trojan Talk.
All right.